Bonjour à tous, si vous vous demandez comment un athlète de haut niveau vit cette quarantaine un petit peu particulière, comment est-ce qu'on s'entretient entre quatre murs, eh bien le meilleur moyen c'est de leur demander. Et pour ça, je vous propose qu'on appelle tout de suite Nadia Nedim, l'attaquante du Paris Saint-Germain. Hey Nadia!
Hey, how are you?
How are you?
Yeah, good, good, how are you?
Yes, me, I'm fine. But you, how are you living this confinement period? You are in Denmark, no?
Yes, I flew back 3 days ago, back to Denmark, okay. You know, before they shut down the airports and everything. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I've been actually really fine, you know. Of course, okay. I miss the football, I miss PSG, I miss my teammates. But thinking about all the situation that's going on in the world, I think I'm happy to be here with my family, okay. And personally, I'm doing great, you know, I'm healthy and in shape, yes. So yeah.
Yes, but how are you keeping up in shape? I'm asking because how do you train at home when you are a forward? I imagine you need to score to go.
So basically, it's because I live on the countryside.
Yes.
And we have a lot of place, a lot of space, but not a lot of people here.
Okay.
So I've been like working in the garden, chopping some wood, you know. I do a lot of like homemade weights, you know. I carry stuff in my bag. I go a lot of running.
Okay.
I train with my ball. You know, I do stuff that I don't really need fancy machines. I don't need the gym mm-hmm. to be able to keep in shape. I just use whatever I have around me. And, you know, as you said, as a striker, you have to maintain your shape. And I think I'm doing decent right now.
Okay, the club give you a program?
Yes, of course. We have Pierre, who's our strength coach. Every day he sends me the program. I do his program, but I also do some of my own stuff, you know, because, yeah, I know I want to do a bit extra, you know. And as I said, you know, I know it's sad, but I think it's also a good timing to maybe improve, you know, some of your weaknesses.
Do you manage to keep in touch with your teammates, with the club?
Yes, of course. Mm-hmm. We have, you know, WhatsApp group where people post a lot, but also individually.
I will call you in the WhatsApp group.
yeah, call me.
A big interview.
but also, you know, your teammates, your friends, I check on them, how they're doing, mm-hmm. how their country, you know, what's going on. And, you know, our physios, our coaches, with Laura, of course, also. So, yeah, we're trying to keep in touch. And nowadays, it's luckily so easy. You can just call or text or snap.
Yes.
So,
yeah. Isn't it too hard to be cut off from your daily life so suddenly?
You know what? It is really hard. I'm not going to lie. I think it's a really new situation for everyone. Not only for me, but I know it's for everyone.
And for me to give interview at home?
Seriously, no. But, you know, but I think... I understand that it's a hard time, but we have to be smart about it because it's not a little thing, you know. You have to imagine why we do this, you know, and it's to protect the ones who are weak, the ones who are in danger. So for me, I'm doing this, I don't like it, it's hard, I don't think it's fun, but I know that I'm helping
some
other people.
It's necessary, yes.
100%, it's necessarily, not only, like, not for you, but the other people, you know, and I think... As a community, as a like human being, you have to sometimes not be so selfish. Not everything is about me, you know. Sometimes also about other people.
Yes.
So in that term, I see the entire picture, and I think it's cool, you know. And I hope that we're gonna get on the other side as soon as possible, and then we can go back to our, you know, daily lives and play some football.
Yes, you speak about it better than me because you are currently studying medicine on top of your soccer career.
Yes.
With both of these roles, what is your eyes on all this crisis on that is happening at this moment?
You know, as I told you, it's not a little thing. You know, it's a pandemic. The entire world is involved right now. And you know, every country is trying to take all the measures necessarily to stop this.
In Denmark too?
Oh, everywhere, yeah. Okay. Denmark was one of the first countries who cut everything down, schools, everything closed. It's kind of similar as in France, you know. So I like this approach. I like it because I know where we can end if we don't do anything. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't know if you heard about it, in 1918 to 1920, you had the Spanish flu,
yes,
which killed a lot of people. And if I think if we're not, we don't take this serious, this could, like, have kind of similar, you know, tendencies.
Mm-hmm.
So, so yeah, I hope that people are going to understand the situation and stay a bit home for a couple of weeks, and then we'll take it from there.
Personally, are you in touch with anyone, any hospital medical staff?
Yeah, of course. My oldest sister is a doctor. My two sister, younger sisters are nurses.
Okay.
So they're working every day. And I want to go as well.
You are in the crisis.
In the crisis. I hear everything beforehand. I have a lot of doctor friends. You know, and also I wanna if the situation is gonna get worse than it is right now, and they're gonna be needing doctors, you know, I'm gonna obviously volunteer, but also know that, like, you know, I think I have to be smart about the situation. You have to look on if we maybe in a couple of weeks are gonna go back. I don't want to take the chances of getting contagious and then maybe bring some of my other teammates in danger. So it's like a balance. But let's see what's going to happen, you know. If it's really, really bad, then I need to put on the white coat and go and save some people.
Okay. Thank you for everything. Before to leave you, I imagine you have any message or recommendation to give to our watcher in your situation.
Yeah, I think, you know, as I said, it's a hard situation. But I think if you want to keep in shape, you can find so many ways to do that.
Yes.
And also, like, for morale, don't be upset, you know, it's temporary, that's not going to last forever. Yes, and I think we're going to get on the other side, you know. So keep that in mind, it's not for the entire life, it's only for 2 weeks, and you can do it. So stay strong and stay at home.
Okay, thank you, stay home, stay safe, and come back us stronger in your mind, in your heart, and in your goals.
Yes, okay. Definitely. Thank you.
Thank you very much, bye.
My pleasure, bye.